गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ सेमिस्टर सेकंड एंड लेट अस सी द एम ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल. इन दिस प्रैक्टिकल वी आर लर्न अबाउट द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ नेफ्रोलिपिस. एज वी लर्न द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ नेफ्रोलिपिस इन थियरी ऑल्सो एंड लेट अस सी ओवर लुक अबाउट दिस प्रैक्टिकल. सिस्टमैटिक पोजिशन. Okay, we know that the systematic position division is the pteridophyta, and the characteristic of pteridophyta is member are non-flowering and vascular plant. The plant body is differentiated into the root, stem and leaves. Third character is the leaves are microphyllous or macrophyllous with or without sporophyll, and the spores may be homo or heterosporous. They may be the same or different in characteristic and shape. The sporangium shows annulus and stomium. These are some characteristic of group division pteridophyta. Class is the Filicini. What is the character of this Filicini? Same as in division, as only one class is present. Filicini, that is only one class is present in the here in Filicini pteridophyta. Subclass is the Leptosporangiate. Leptosporangiate, development of sporangium from a single cell. Leptosporangiate, that sporangium form only single cell, that is the characteristic of this subclass. Order is Filicels. Sporangia are homosporous. In this order the sporangia is homosporous. Family Polypodiaceae. The sori are mixed type, annulus vertical, and gametophyte has heart shape. These are the characteristic of the Polypodiaceae. Sori are mixed type, annulus vertical, and gametophyte is heart shape. Next one is the genus. Genus is Nephrolepis. Characteristic, leaves are pinnately compound, presence of hadathode and the true indusium, and sori are kidney shape. Okay, these are some these are about the systematic position. Next one is the external morphology. How that plant look? Let us see in the figure. The plant having the rhizome, okay, at the basal side, that at the underside of the rhizome, the roots, small adventitious root-like structure is present, and from the rhizome, the leaf-like structure is present here. Okay, this is the external structure of the sporophyte of Nephrolepis. The sporophyte of Nephrolepis is dominant, autotrophic, well developed with the true root, stem and leaves. Autotrophic, they produce as their own food material. Let us see one by one the root. Root, the adventitious root develop from the modified underground stolon, and the roots are branched, persistent with a long root here. Okay, this is the about the root. How that externally root are seen, that is adventitious root. Stem, the stem is stout, vertical, obliquely pressed and underground, called as a rhizome, and that means the stem is in the form of rhizome. Such rhizome is called as the caudex also. Okay, rhizome or caudex. The surface of the caudex is rough. Why? Because of the surface of the caudex is rough due to the scales called as the ramenta, and some stolon grows vertically in the green and covered with the ramenta. So it is somewhat rough structure that caudex or stem having. Okay, next one, the leaves. The leaves are pinnately compound like the neem leaf, and they are spirally arranged on the caudex. The leaf can be differentiated into the basal petiole called as the stipe, and the upper leafy portion called as the frond. The stipe is smooth without appendages and a brown in color. The frond consists of the central axis called as the rachis, having alternate arrangement of the pinna. Pinna is nothing but the leaflet. Okay, on the rachis that pinna is arranged like the neem leaf, only one rachis is there, and on the both side that small leaflet are arises. The young leaf is coiled from apex downward, called as the sarcenate tissix. The single leaflet is sessile, small, lanceolate in shape, having acute apex and sarcenate margin. The lamina consists of a single vein at the center with number of forked vilets, and the upper surface of the lamina at the margin present the number of glands called as the hadathodes. We know that the hadathodes, okay, small opening, okay, on the veins, or chalk gland. They are present at the end of veinlets and are in two rows, one along each margin. There is a depression present at the center of each hadathode and which excludes water, leaving behind the white minerals. Okay, the main function of that hadathode is nothing but to exude the excess amount of water from the plant. Okay, and that water which is exude from the plant, that exude from the plant, that having not only the water but that having only some mineral, and when that water is transpirate or it is evaporate, the small white mineral dot are present on that leaf. On the lower surface of the leaflet, there are group of sporangia seen near the margin of each leaf, and each spora is protected by kidney shaped scale called as the indusium. Okay, in this way, this is about the leaf. Let us see this structure here. In first figure, small dot like structure is there. Okay, and veins are there. Okay, in second structure, when we take the section of that part, hadathode is there. Okay, hadathode, it is nothing but the central cells, okay, that having the, or that having the pores, and that loose from that central part only the water can be loses, and which is surrounded by the epidermal cells. Okay, this is about the hadathode. And next one is the ramenta. Ramenta having different part, outermost scales are there, then the processes are there, and point of attachment of there, they are having the ramenta. Internal structure of the sporophyll. Sporophyll means the leaf. Okay, let us see in this first figure. These are the sporophyll, because that dotted structure is nothing but the spore. Okay, what is meant sporophyll? The leaf which having the spore, that is known as the sporophyll. Let us see in this diagram, the black dotted structure, that is the sporophyll, and the leaflet of Neprolepis bear the spore producing structure at the maturity, hence called as the sporophyll. Each sporophyll is isobilateral and shows the following layer. First one is the epidermis. We know that the epidermis is the upper, and lower epidermis consists of tubular cells which are compactly arranged and possesses the chloroplast. The stomata are restricted to the lower epidermis only. The upper epidermis consists of depression at the vein ending is due to the hadathodes. The lower epidermis shows the presence of sori at the vein endings. Each sorus consists of the placenta, sporangia and indusium. Next one is the mesophyll tissue. These the all cells, when we see this structure, when we take a section of that leaf, okay, and how that yes transfer section are taken, that slide or that video is placed in your Google Classroom. Please see that video, how we take a section of leaf stem or root. Okay, procedure is same, and when we take a section, this internal structure, epidermis, mesophyll tissue, vascular bundle, they are seen under the microscope. Mesophyll tissue, the cells, all the cells, they are thin walled, chlorenchymatous and loosely arranged. Vascular bundle, vascular bundle produced due to the central vein is cut transversely, while veinlets are cut longitudinally. The vascular bundle is conjoint, concentric and amphivessel type, and that is the vascular tissue is surrounded by the phloem tissue. Vascular xylem tissue is present at the center, and that are surrounded by the phloem tissue when we take a section. Next one is the structure of sporangia. Okay, each sporangia of Nephrolepis consists of the stalk and body or capsule. Let us see in the figure. Capsule shaped structure is there, and they having a small stalk and body of capsule. Stalk, it is the basal, multicellular, slender and attached to the placenta. Body or capsule, it is biconvex. It is covered with the single layer jacket. That green color single layer jacket is there. Most of the cell are thin wall except few thick wall large size with the vertical row called as the annulus. Okay, let us see here some cells, they having the annulus here. Okay, and that annulus, these cells help in the dehiscence of the sporangium. That annulus cell or they are responsible for the dehiscence of sporangium, and this region is also called as the stomium. Also from the part from where the dehiscence can be start or opening can be developed for the spore, that opening is known as the stomium also. Okay, this is about the structure of sporangia. Let us see the structure of spore. In sporangia, the yellow colored, let us see in the figure, yellow colored spore is there. Each spore is the tetrahedral and brown in color. The wall of the spore is double layered. Let us see in the figure. Double layer structure is there. Outer exine, inner intine. The outer exine shows the number of projecting folds known as the ornamentation. This is about the structure of spore. Structure of gametophyte. We know that the gametophyte is heart shape. Okay. And that heart shape structure at the basal side, there are the rhizoid. Above that, the antheridia is there, and at the near the notch, archegonia is there. The prothallus of Nephrolepis develop after the germination of the spores. It is half inch in diameter, only half inch. The gametophyte is, or the diameter of gametophyte is, and it is heart shape, dorsiventrally flat. The prothallus is single layered thick except at the notch. At the notch, it is somewhat thickened layered. Okay, it is multi-layered and are form a cushion-like structure. All the cell are chlorenchymatous, green except ventrally located rhizoid. Okay, rhizoid is not green, other part is the green in color. The rhizoid are unicellular, tubular, and fix the gametophyte to the soil. The reproductive organ, antheridia and archegonia, are produced on the same thallus, hence it is homothallic structure. The antheridia are produced toward the basal region, while the archegonia are produced toward the notch of prothallus. This is about the gametophyte or structure of gametophyte. I hope you are understand that in practical we take a section of leaf, and after taking a section of leaf we see the structure of sporangium. Okay, let us see from this leaf we take a section, and after taking a section we see the different structure, epidermis or different part, like here shown in this slide. Epidermis, mesophyll tissue, vascular bundle and sporangium are also seen there. I hope you are understand that. Thank you. Thank you very much.